Hi there, welcome to Questacon's Science Time. I'm BJ.
And I'm Dion.
And today we're talking about water. Come and join us.
Wake up, sun and moon. It's science time. It's science time. Wake up, skeleton. It's science time. It's science time. At home, in the bathroom, when we're swimming, there is science. Outside, at the playground, in the sunshine, there is science. Wake up.
What do we use water for? We use water every day. What's some of the things? Swimming. Yeah. Who went swimming over the holidays? I love swimming. What's something else we use water for?
Drinking.
Who likes to drink water? Yum. Yeah. What else do we use water for?
Turtles.
You have pet turtles, don't you? And they live in water. Does anyone have any pets at home that lives in water, like fish? You don't have fish? I don't have fish. But you do. You do, don't you?
I used to.
You used to have fish, did you?
We put them in the filter where the turtles tried. The filter killed them.
Oh, yeah, fish are
quite... I blame the filter.
You blame the filter for that. Yeah, yeah, I would too, yeah. And did you say the beach? Yeah, there's water at the beach, isn't there? Yep. What else do we use water for at home? What happens when you go to the toilet and you press the button?
Flush.
It flushes all the water. Flushes, doesn't it?
And you have water to wash dishes.
To wash the dishes, we use water. Well done. Yeah. What else do we use water for?
To wash our hands.
Yeah. And we can wash our whole bodies in water, can't we?
Yeah. Showers.
Like showers and baths. Do you like to have baths? I like to have baths. Yeah, yeah. You like baths? Oh, I love baths. So we use water every single day. Lots of things we use water for.
And sometimes you can make a bath in the shower by blocking the hole.
You can have a shower and a bath at the same time, can't you? Yeah. Yeah, do you? Now, I've got some toys we're going to play with today because some things float in water and some things sink in water. So we're going to have a look at some pictures now. Here are some pictures. Turn around so you can see the picture. Here's a picture of a boat. Now, does a boat float on top of the water or sink to the bottom of the water? It floats, doesn't it? Do you think a boat floats? Well, let's do an experiment and find out. So here's our boat and here's our water. We're going to put the boat on. So do you think it might float on top or sink to the bottom? What do you think? Here we go. Yeah, it floats on top, doesn't it? Boats float really well. There we go. Out you come, boat. What's our next picture? Beach balls. What do you think beach balls do? Float on top of the water or sink to the bottom? What do you think?
Float?
Well, I don't have... Yeah, here we go. I've got a balloon, haven't I? I haven't got a beach ball, but I've got a balloon.
Yeah.
And it's full of air as well. So, let's see if it floats or sinks. What do you think's going to happen? Let's experiment. Are we ready? Yeah, it floats on top of the water. It floats really well, doesn't it? Because it's full of air. There we go. What's our next picture? What animal's this one? What does a duck say?
Quack, quack.
Does a duck float on top of the water?
Yeah.
You think so? Yeah. I got a little duck here, don't I? Thank you. Let's do our experiment. What do you think? Do you think it will float or sink?
Yeah.
Do you think so? Let's have a look. Here it goes. Quack, quack. Yeah, it floats on top. But he fell over a bit, didn't he? He must be a tired duck. But he floats on top of the water. Well done, duck. Quack, quack, you're welcome. Quack, quack, quack. And what's our next picture? What about people? You know, people can float on the water too. Have you ever floated on the water? Maybe wearing a life vest or your floaties? Yep. Do you like floating on the water? I do. Yep. What else do we have? Oh, a piece of wood. Do you think a piece of wood would float on top or sink to the bottom?
Sink to the bottom.
Good guessing. Floating, sinking. I think we need to do an experiment to find out. Thank you, helper. You're a good helper. So here's a piece of wood. Let's see if it floats or sinks. What do you think's going to happen? Let's have a look. Wow, I thought it might sink as well, but look, it's floating on top of the water. Wow, wood is very good at floating.
But there's nothing on
that ground. Well, here we go. You're right, I haven't had any sinking things yet, have I?
Rocks sink because they're so heavy.
Rocks are very heavy, aren't they? And rocks might sink because they're heavy. What do you think is going to happen to the rock? Do you think it will sink or float? What do you think? Let's find out. We ready? You ready, everyone? Yeah, it sunk right to the bottom, didn't it? Yeah, that went straight down. Well done. Okay, what else have we got here? Ice. This is a big iceberg. And I've got a big piece of ice. My assistant is helping here. Thanks, sweetheart. I've got a big chunk of ice here. It's actually really quite heavy. What do you think? Have a feel. Is the ice warm or cold?
Cold.
It's cold. Yes, it is. Can you feel it? It's all cold and wet. Can you feel it?
Yeah.
Oh, did it wet your trousers? Here's a towel for you. There you go. Okay, ready, everyone? What do you think's going to happen? Do we think it will float or sink? Because it's quite heavy. Let's see, I'm going to stand up for this one. Ready? Oh, wow, sitting down, look. It floats. Wow, it floats on top of the water.
And not the rock.
No, the rock still sunk, didn't it? Yeah. So even heavy things like this ice can float on top. Here's one more picture I want to show you. And this is a picture of a big boat, a big heavy boat that can float on top of the water. How do you think a big heavy boat like this can float on water? Do you have any ideas?
Because it's got air.
Because there's certainly lots of air inside there as well. It's all got to do with the shape of the boat. So here, I've got two pieces of plasticine. They're the same amount, so they're the same weight, but are they the same shape?
No.
No, they're quite different shapes, aren't they? This one is round, and this one's hollowed out like a little boat shape. Now I'm going to take our ice out. Out you come, wet, drippy ice. Put you in there. And let's put our plasticines in the water. Do you think they're going to float or sink? Do you think they're both going to do the same thing?
No, the round one's going to sink and the big one's going to float.
Good thinking. What do you think? And boys and girls at home, what do you think's going to happen? Do you think they will float or sink? Are we ready to do an experiment and find out?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Wow, look, one sunk and one is floating. But I'm going to change the shape of this one now. So I'm going to squash it up. And look, it's not like a boat anymore. Do you think it's going to float or sink? It sunk right to the bottom. So I'm going to change the shape back to a boat shape. Change it back to our round, curvy boat. So now it's got a big surface area and it can push lots of water out of the way. And it floats. Wow, isn't that great? So some things in water float and some things sink. We got lots and lots of things to play with in Science Time today. So are we ready to have some fun? Ready, set, go! Go have a play!
Put it on top, it'll stop raining. If you let go again, it'll start raining again. And stop raining. So while everyone's playing, I want to show you something special at QuestaCon. Come with me.
Hi everyone, we're here at Questacon's H2O Soak Up the Science Gallery. I have something very special to show you. Here we have some ice. Now, is ice warm or cold? It's pretty cold, isn't it? Now, when water gets really, really cold, it turns into ice. And ice is a solid. You can see, it's really, really hard. Now, when ice gets warm, what happens to it? It turns into water, doesn't it? And this is some water right here. Now, water is a liquid, which means we can pour it, we can drink it, we can even splash it. You can't do that with a solid though. That's why liquids are really special. Now we've got lots of things to have a look at Questacon's H2O Soak Up the Science Gallery. Let's see what's here. Can you hear the thunder? A storm is coming. So where does water come from? Have you ever been out in the rain? Water comes from clouds and falls from the sky as rain. The water fills up lakes, rivers, and even the ocean. Now, lots of things live in the sea and in water. Do you know any animals that live in water? Yeah, fish live in the water. Do any other living things need water to live? Yeah, we need water too. But we drink it instead of live in it. All living things, animals, humans, and plants, all need water to live. Water is really important stuff. And it's fun to play with too. You can splash water, swim in water. It's great fun. Wow, so many different types of water. Let's go back to science time, see what they're up to.
So over here, come sit on the mat. I've got something to show you before we finish science time today. A little bit of a water demonstration. So here I've got two glasses, one with water and one without water. I'm going to move all the water from this cup without touching it. And I'm not going to pour it. I'm going to use my bendy straw. You ready? I'm going to use my mouth to get it started a little bit. So, do you see how the water is pouring down the straw? From the top cup to the bottom cup. That's called siphoning. The water's being siphoned out of the top cup and it's going into the bottom cup. Do you see how well it's pouring? You see, little water molecules, they like to stick together. They pour really well. And look, they're both the same amount of water now, but it's going to keep pouring. Now which one has more water? The bottom one's got more water, doesn't it?
Yeah, because you're pouring that on this one
into the other one.
Yeah! And look, the top one is now empty. Wow! So we moved all the water from the one glass into the other glass without pouring. How clever is that?
Can I have a go?
Oh, we'll have a go in a moment. I've got something for you to take home with you first, though. Now, parents, we've got an information sheet. And boys and girls at home, you can find this on our website. It talks a bit about what we did in science time today, and it shows you how you can make rain bottles at home as well. So Dion, can you give those to all of our grown-ups, please? There you go. And boys and girls, one last question. Where does water come from?
Outside.
Outside. And where from outside?
The clouds.
The clouds. The clouds make it rain.
Rain.
And here's someone in the rain and they've got their umbrella. This is a colouring in for you to take home. And boys and girls at home, this colouring in sheet is on our website. And here, she's got an umbrella. You can colour that any colour you like. And she's got gumboots on in a big puddle. Who likes to splash in puddles? Yeah, me too. So now it's time to say bye, everyone. Can we say bye? And can you look at the boys and girls at home and say bye?
Bye.
See you next science time.
See you next science time.
Bye. See you later. Here we go. Questacon Science Time is held at Questacon in Canberra, Tuesday to Friday during school terms. Bookings are essential. For further information, go to our website at questacon.edu.au. See you next Science Time.